started at 8 at the actual boxing gym, but I think I started about 2 years earlier doing pads when I was about 6 with my dad for a couple of years, and then we went down to Hayes Boxing Gym originally with Mark and Frank Connolly, and that's when I got started. One of the earliest, other than obviously the first time I went down the boxing gym, which I remember looking at the clock about 15 minutes in and thinking I'd been there for about 2 hours and I was going to pass out. But watching the highlights of Ricky Hatton's knockouts and fights, I don't even know how old I was then, but well, I must have been about 8-ish, but that's my earliest memory. Sparring, a couple. Dean Richardson obviously hits unbelievable hard. He's what, 4-0-4 knockouts now. Ryan Toms hits hard. I've done a little bit of sparring with him just before I started training camp in preparation for his last fight, which he won by a knockout. And an old amateur teammate who I don't think boxes anymore, Archie Hutchins, got probably the hardest, well, every shot he throws is rock solid, but his jab, the right hand you wouldn't mind because you can slip it, but the jab would break everything you hit. Best trainer was Jack Hughes, who's had 3 now, 1-2, lost his debut. For his first 3 fights, the hardest trainer I've ever seen. He was, if he weren't in the gym, he was harassing Barry and the boys about when are we in the gym, what can I do? And when he was in there, he was working non-stop. Jack Hughes again, but this is Jack Hughes since his 3 fights. Yeah, I know he's not in training camp at the moment, but he's got a little bit lazy. He likes going out drinking and eating a load of shit and talking a load of rubbish in the group chats, but that's about it. No, it's got to be a toss-up between a pizza from Domino's, but literally any pizza from Domino's, Chinese, or a curry, to be fair. Anything. I'm not fussy after the fight. Just go out, have a takeaway, and a beer. That's it. Well, my strength and conditioning coach now, who obviously, well, I say strength and conditioning, I do my strength work with him, but he's boxing trainer, Les Subby. He's always told me since I started, punches make prizes, which, it can't get more simple than that, can it? Like, without throwing punches, you ain't gonna win the fight, so. I had a kid on Twitter tell me that boxing is just about hitting your opponent harder than they hit you, and there's nothing more to it. I would be if I met some of the ones actually like that much. If I met Ricky Hatton, I'd probably be starstruck or like Mayweather, but from who I've met, I don't know, not particularly. It's nice to be in the gym around some of the bigger names like George Groves once or twice, John O'Donnell all the time, like people that have been to the top level. It's nice, but I wouldn't say I've been starstruck.
Is that more because they're laid back?
Yeah. They don't act like anyone else when they're in the gym, they're down to earth, they get involved with all the lads, so it's always been nice really, rather than feeling like they are superstars, but you don't really feel like they are until you realise who it is after. There's a few. I don't know if it's probably one of the most entertaining fights, but one of the ones I enjoyed the most was George Groves, James DeGale. Obviously they're fighters pros at the O2, because I went down there with my dad, and obviously I trained at Del Youth where both of them started off, so that was good to see. I've got a few. Seen a few good amateur fighters as well, to be fair. Jack Newham, who's got his pro debut on September 9th, can't remember all of his opponents' names in the amateurs, but pretty much every time I went to watch him, that was entertaining fight. He's got an engine on him and likes to throw a load of punches, so he's stuck in, having a proper tear up. And to be fair, I'd say one of my own fights, and obviously I didn't watch it in person, but watching it back as an amateur after, I boxed out in a boy from Small Holdings boxing gym, and I was two rounds down going into the last round. I remember my dad telling me I've got to knock him out to win. And watching the video back at the last round, I don't think it was possible to throw any more punches than I did in that round. And fair play to the boy for standing up the whole time. He still won, unfortunately, but he shouldn't have. Football, and I think most people that know me by now know I support Brentford. We're not far from there at the moment, so if it's match day, I could take you down there.
I'd rather not.
Yeah, but Brentford, football and boxing, really, that's about it. Brentford and me. past, I'm going to go with Julian Jackson, I think. It's mostly down to the fact that he hits, well, from what I've seen, he hits so unbelievably hard, and I'd just like to get in there and test my chin against that, see how hard he really hits. But also, on the other hand, I think he lost all six of his losses are by knockout, so I'd like to test his chin as well.
Okay, and present?
Present, I've got a couple. Conor McGregor, if he sticks with the boxing, because I think he's just there for the taking for anyone, really. Anyone that's half decent, I'm ranked higher than him. Canelo, because I think his career has been unbelievable considering how young he turned pro. What was he, like 15 or something like that? Which I think he'll beat Golovkin in their fight coming up. And then in Britain, you've got a few like domestically and some smaller names, like not people I necessarily would say I want to fight now, but in the future, I'd like to see if I can get to their level and how good they are. People like Ted Cheeseman, Liam Smith, Liam Williams, like some of the people that are like British level and below at the moment, but are still quite a big step ahead of me. I'd like to see how well I do against them, really. I'm Ricky Heavens, and I just went 12 rounds of Southpaw Jab.